Hello my dear students, welcome to my class. I am Anjum Sheikh. In previous class, we have discussed about the important natural resources, forests and wildlife. Why there is a need to conserve the forest and wildlife? Why the forests are known as the lungs of the world? Do you know that the Amazon forests are known as the lungs of the world because of their importance for us? Today we are going to discuss about very important natural resource, water. Water for all. Now see the image. What do you see in this image? This image is from a village and the villagers are suffering from chronic water shortage. See, they have to work hard to get the supply of water, and though they are not getting the clean water. You know that getting enough and clean plenty water is our basic right. But these people are far away from their basic right. They have to struggle to get the water. And now see the next image. What do we observe? This is an image of water park. You can see the people are enjoying in the water park. So plenty of water is being wasted. Do you think it is fair? In first image, we have seen that people are struggling for water, and in second image, you can see that people are enjoying in the water park. You know that lots of water is wasted daily in the water park just for the enjoyment of people. You know that water is a basic necessity for all terrestrial forms of life. Life is non-existent without this precious resource. That's why we should save water. Do you know water is known as a universal solvent? Why? Because water dissolves so many substances. That's why it is also called as the universal solvent. For example, it can dissolve the solid substances. For example, cubes of sugar added to tea, salt and soap. These solid substances can be dissolved in the water, sugar, salt and soap. Then liquids such as bleach, rubbing alcohol can easily mix with water. Even gases also like oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. These gases get dissolved in water, and these dissolved gases are important for organisms that live in the water. That's why the water is very important natural resource. Even most of the part of our body, it needs water. Here you can see the rainfall pattern in India in 2019. So in this presentation, the dark blue color represents the large excess rainfall, then light blue represents excess, green normal, yellow deficient, orange large deficient, and dark orange, it represents the no rainfall. So here you may see that some states of India like Punjab, Chhattisgarh, some parts of Maharashtra like Vidarbha, in the year 2019 there was excess rainfall, large excess rainfall, while in states such as Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, Chhattisgarh, some parts of Maharashtra, then Telangana, coastal Andhra Pradesh, etc. There was excess rainfall. While the states like West Madhya Pradesh, East UP, Jammu and Kashmir, there was deficient rainfall, means there was shortage of water. While there are some areas where there was no rain at all, for example, West Rajasthan, then parts of Gujarat such as Saurashtra and Kutch, Assam and Meghalaya. While in states such as Bihar, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, etc., there was normal rainfall. A study of rainfall patterns does not reveal the whole truth behind the water availability in various regions in India. Rains in India are largely due to the monsoons. This means that most of the rain falls in a few months of the year. So there should be water irrigation systems so that they will ensure that water will be available throughout the year. So these are examples of some of the irrigation methods. For example, dams, canals, wells, tanks. So these water irrigation methods ensure that the farmers as well as the local people will get water throughout the year. Now here are some ancient methods of water harvesting. For example, in Rajasthan, khadins, tanks, etc. Then in Maharashtra, bandharas. Then Madhya Pradesh and UP, that is Uttar Pradesh, bandis are the ancient methods of water harvesting. While in Bihar, pines and ahars. See, these are also the traditional wells, which ensure that the people will get supply of water throughout the year. Here you may see the image of bandharas in Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, these bandharas are very common. You will find this bandhara in most of the villages on the water resources. Kuls in Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh had a canal irrigation system called as Kuls, where flowing stream water was diverted to man-made channels, which took it to villages down the hillside. The water was used first by the village farthest from the origin of the pool. So it helped water to percolate in the soil. After government irrigation system took over, the practice was affected. Now what are dams? A dam is a barrier that stops or restricts the flow of water or underground streams. Reservoirs created by dams not only suppress floods but also provide water for activities such as irrigation, human consumption, industrial use, aquaculture and navigability. What are the advantages of dams? Dams are said to be an important source of water supply and high importance for various other reasons. Dams supply the water for the various means, including domestic use, irrigation purposes, and also for the industrial uses. Dams are also involved in the hydroelectric power generation and in the river navigation. The applications of these dams is much more important in daily activities, including cooking, cleaning, bathing, washing, drinking water for the water as well as water for the gardening and for the cultivation purpose. The big dams and the reservoirs also provide recreational areas for the purpose of fishing as well as boating. People can go for picnic near the big dams as well as reservoirs and enjoy there. They also cater the insecurity needs of humans by reducing or by preventing the floods. This is the major role played by the dams, that they help to prevent the floods. During the times of excess flow of water, the dams store the water in the reservoir. Later, they release that water during the times of low flow. Also, when the natural flow of water are inadequate to meet the demand. When engineers design and also maintain the dams, they are keenly expected to make sure to keep all purposes in their mind. You might have heard about the Narmada Bachao Andolan. Though dams are very useful for us, but there are certain problems associated with the construction of dams. In the previous chapter, we have discussed about the reasons for opposition to the construction of large dams, such as Tehri Dam on the river Ganga. You must have read about the protests by the Narmada Bachao Andolan. That means Save the Narmada movement about raising the height of the Sardar Sarovar Dam on the river Narmada. The Narmada Bachao Andolan or Save the Narmada movement, it is said to be the most powerful mass movement. It was started by a social worker named Medha Patkar. The social movement, it was a social movement by tribal people, that is Adivasis, farmers, environmentalists and the human rights activists against the Sardar Sarovar Dam being built across the Narmada River in Gujarat. The focus of the movement was saving the trees and the fauna as well as rehabilitation of the poor people living around the area. This movement started in the year 1986 when the World Bank lent India $450 million for the Sardar Sarovar project. See, this is most powerful mass movement which was started by a social work named Medha Patkar. The problems associated with the construction of large dams are, there are three problems associated with the construction of large dams. The first problem is social problems. When dams are constructed, large number of people are displaced without adequate compensation and rehabilitation. So this is the major problem. Whenever dams are being constructed, the people living in that area, they have to leave their houses as well as their fertile land, and wherever they are displaced, they are not given adequate compensation. So this is the major problem associated with the construction of dams. Then second problem is economic problems. The dams swallow up huge amounts of public money without the generation of proportionate benefits. You know that large amount of money is required for the construction of dams. It requires millions of dollars, and this money comes from the public tax. That means dams swallow up huge amounts of public money without the generations of proportionate benefits. Though dams are beneficial, but their benefits are obtained by after so many years. Then third problem associated with construction of dams is environmental problems. Dams contribute enormously to deforestation as well as the loss of biological diversity. So these are the three main problems associated with construction of dams. First is social problem, second economic problem, and third is environmental problems. Generally this question is asked in board exam for 3 marks. So you should be aware about the problems associated with the construction of large dams. Now next is water harvesting, means saving water for the future purpose. The water harvesting encourages soil and water conservation in order to sustain and increase the biomass. It increases income for the local community. It also helps to prevent the floods and droughts. For example, Rajasthan's tanks, khadins and nadins, Maharashtra's tals and bandharas, Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh bundis, Bihar's pines and ahars, then Himachal Pradesh cools, kattas in Karnataka, ponds in Kandi belt of Jammu region and eris in Tamil Nadu, and in Kerala, surangams. So these are the various water harvesting systems. These constructions are crescent shaped earthen embankments or concrete check dams built in areas that are seasonally flooded. The main purpose is to recharge the groundwater. See, the main purpose of water harvesting is to recharge the groundwater. Now, what are the advantages of storing water in the ground? First advantage is it does not evaporate. This is the first advantage, that groundwater does not evaporate. Second advantage is it spreads out to recharge wells. That means that water can be used by the wells in the nearby areas. It also provides moisture for vegetation over a wide area. It does not provide breeding ground for mosquitoes. This is the important advantage of storing water underground, that it does not provide the breeding ground for the mosquitoes. This water is protected from contamination by human as well as animal wastes. Do you know about India's waterman? Dr. Rajendra Singh is an Indian water conservationist and environmentalist from the Alwar district in Rajasthan. He won the Magsaysay Award in 2001 and Stockholm Water Prize in 2015. He runs an NGO called Tarun Bharat Sangh, which was founded in the year 1975. see the image of India's waterman. Due to his various techniques, the water has been saved in Rajasthan, and Alwar district has been converted into the lush green area due to the efforts of Dr. Rajendra Singh. So for his awards, for his efforts, he was awarded by the 2015 Stockholm Water Prize, Mr. Rajendra Singh. The traditional water harvesting system includes khadins. It is the traditional water harvesting structure of Rajasthan. It is also called as Dhora. Its main feature is that it consists of long earthen embankment. It is around 100 to 300 meters long. It is built across the lower hill slopes lying below the uplands, and spillways in the areas are allow excess water to drain off to the catchment. So this was all about the water, about the important natural resource water, its importance, then various systems of irrigation, benefits of dams, as well as the harmful effects of the dams and traditional water harvesting system. In next video, we will be discussing about another important natural resource, coal and petroleum. Thank you.